I have a job for you. It's Gunner's meat. And my face was like, Gunner's meat? Me? Gunner's meat? Guns? Do you see me? Gunner's mate, though? That was the only job he could offer me with a 60 on the ASVAB? Baby, no.
My bullshit, back up on the move. Touchdown in my hometown, got nothing to lose. I am on my own.
What's up, YouTube? It's your girl, Queen, and I'm back here with another video. I know y'all see my setup is different. I'm in the car, and I just figure, why not make a video? The sun is shining for once. Where I live at, trying to get used to coming on camera and not being so perfect, but like being more on a personal level. So we gonna get personal, okay? This is Naturally Queen, no makeup, no weave, coming to you bare, natural, raw, uncut. So the one thing I want to say when it comes to picking your job, do not, I repeat, do not let them pick the job for you. You let them pick the job for you, they're gonna give you the job that best fits the Navy's needs, and you'll end up miserable. I'm one of the lucky ones. I have probably the second best job in the Navy, and I can get a little bit more into that. Comment down low if y'all want to know my job, what I do. So when I went to MEPS, of course I did the typical physical screening that you do. They did a physical. I can't really remember all of it. That part you don't got to worry about. The part that you really, really want to worry about is when you get in there with the detailer and you pick your job, your career for the next 4 to 5 years. When you sign that contract, that's what you need to be very, very concerned about. You need to be very vigilant. You need to read, ask questions. Do not let them sell you into a job, because what you'll notice is a lot of the times that's what they will do. That's exactly what they'll do. They'll sell you into a job. They'll get you to go undesignated. They'll tell you undesignated, oh, you're gonna go in without a job, but when you get in, you'll be able to pick any job you want. Lies. Undesignated people end up getting stuck being BMs, which are boatsman's mate, which means they do the most labor, from painting the ship, and you know, like, BMs work hard. They do strike a job eventually, but you have to go through a year and a half to 2 years of BS. Like, who wants to do that? Nobody. I like to have my stuff secure. My bag need to be secure, my career, my job, everything needs to be secured, period. So I was not leaving that MEPS office until my stuff was secure. We got to the part of picking a job. I can remember just sitting there. We sat there for hours. Like, we sat there for a long time. And actually, I was like one of the last people to go into the detailer's office. I think we got there at like 6 a.m. and we finished our medical screening part. By that time, it might have been like 8 a.m. And from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m., I was literally just sitting in a room waiting. That's what the military do. They pretty much tell you to shut up, sit down, and wait. So by the time I got into the detailer's office to pick my job, they claimed there was no jobs left. It was like, oh, detailer. He's like, oh, there's no jobs left. Mind you, I had a 60 on the ASVAB, which is very good for the Navy, being that the highest score for the Navy they want you to have is like a 30. They want you to do better than 30% of people who take the ASVAB. I did better than 60%, which I actually qualified for the Air Force. I did my ASVAB with the Air Force. As I told y'all before, my original plan was the Air Force. So I had a 60, which should have unlocked me to a lot of jobs, being that the minimum requirement for the Navy is about a 30, meaning you can be dumb as bricks and you can get into the Navy. I'm just joking, because the ASVAB score definitely doesn't determine your level of knowledge. But again, I did study. I'm gonna try to hurry up because the sun is starting to go down and I have things to do. Currently at Walmart right now, off topic. But yeah, so he tried to tell me there wasn't any jobs left. And he was like, he pulled out a piece of paper off the printer and was like, I have a job for you. It's Gunner's meat. And my face was like, Gunner's meat? Me? Gunner's meat? Guns? Do you see me? And I was cute too that day, okay? Like, I had my little Letterman jacket on, my little AK Letterman jacket on, hair was done, eyebrows. I was cute. I was ready. I was about my business. Gunner's mate, though, that was the only job he could offer me with a 60 on the ASVAB. Baby, no, I was not doing it. I straight up said no. He was like, really? I was like, no. He was like, so you're really gonna like turn this opportunity down? I'm like, yeah. So he's like, so what are you gonna do then? I'm like, I'll go back to my civilian job, working for the school system. He's like, I'm gonna give you one piece of advice when it comes to the military. Never turn anything down without negotiating. And I'm like, what's the negotiation? You literally told me you had one job left and it was gunner's mate, and I'm not signing a contract with gunner's mate. Like, I'm not doing it. I'm not getting stuck being no GM, having to break down guns and do maintenance on guns. Like, yeah, I know their advancement rate isn't too bad, but no. I wanted to do the job that, a job that was going to transfer over good into the civilian world, but also where it was the least amount of labor possible. Yes, I joined wanting to do the least work possible, because if you think about it, it's smart. We're all getting paid the same amount of money. Why would I go bust my butt and do all this hard, sweaty, you know, moving stuff and working long hours when I can do something simple, have more free time, less work, and still get paid? Think smarter, not harder. So, long story short, by the end of it, I walked up out the recruiting office. I mean, not recruiting office, sorry, the MEPS office. I was like, peace. I was like, I'm not signing no contract with that. I don't care what you tell me. Like, I was set. Anybody know me? I'm stubborn. When I said no, I meant no. And there was nothing he was going to do to change it. So I leave up out there. I leave. And, you know, I go home. And, of course, go back to work the next day. And I'm sitting there and I'm just thinking about it. And I'm thinking and I'm thinking. So I ended up calling the guy who I met before I even decided to switch over to the Navy. He had previously been a recruiter. And he was a friend of a friend. So I called him and told him about my experience and what happened. And, you know, he just gave me some positive insight. And he just let me know, like, Queen, it's really not even about the job. Think about all the countries you're going to be seeing. Think about the bigger purpose you're going to be serving. Like, you know, he kind of gave me, like, a better mindset about it. Because, like, I didn't really trust that detailer. Because at the end of the day, his job is to meet a quota. His job is to put people in the Navy. He don't care about me. He don't care about my misery. He don't care about me getting into a job and hating it and not being able to get out my contract or switch my job. And that's another thing. Don't let them tell you, oh, you can just cross rate. You can just switch over to another job. It's not that simple. If you're in a job that's high demand and there's not a lot of people in that job, you're not going to be able just to switch over, because they need you in that job. You're the needs of the Navy. The Navy don't care. The military do not care about what you want. They don't care about what you need. They care about what serves the country, what serves the organization as a whole. So I left up out of there, and I'm gonna try to make this real quick because, like I said, I'm losing sun and I got stuff to do. But I left up out of there and I talked to my friend. The next day I, you know, called the school, like, called principal, hey, I'm not gonna be able to come in. I gotta go do something for the military. I went back, okay? I went back with a different mindset. I prayed on it. I meditated. I asked God to pretty much lead me in the right direction. And when I sat down with him this time, there was no one in the office but other, like, detailers. There was, like, no other recruits in the office. And, like, literally all the detailers swarmed the desk. Of course, they were all men. And they all pretty much was just telling me, like, yo, the job you want is OS. Like, operation specialist is the job you want. And they were just saying, like asking me how much do I make in my current position. And I told them, and they was like, oh, well, you'll make this amount. They told me I have a quick advancement rate, which I did. They told me I would make E5 fast and be able to get BAH and pay raises and stuff, which that was the truth. They didn't lie. They told me I wouldn't really be doing no work. Like, whenever we're on land and not out to sea, I barely would do work. They didn't lie, because I don't. I literally be going home at like 11 a.m. every day. Sometimes the latest I'll be there maybe is like 1 p.m. Everybody else hates it. They hate my division because we got it good. We got it made. Like, on Tuesdays and Thursdays, our job is literally to come to work, muster, have a little meeting, and then we go PT. We go work out, play football, play basketball, do something, some physical activity. We do that Tuesday, Thursdays. Fridays, we volunteer. So it's like we're getting paid to volunteer and to work out and to pretty much come to work and meet and leave. Like, it's made. Like, in port, like, on land, it's made. Our only issue is when we're out to sea, it can get hectic, depending on the watch schedule and like your schedule. But yeah, so they told me that, and they also just was like, you know, it's not a lot of labor, like OS is the job you want. So yeah, that's the one thing, the piece of advice I gotta give y'all. When you go do your researches, when they give you a list of jobs, you tell them, hold on, I need to look these jobs up. Read about it. Get on your phone if you got to. If you gotta leave up out of there and come back the next day with a better decision, then do that, because that's what I did. Like, whatever you do, have an idea before you go into the detailer's office of what jobs you want. Like, actually, I actually researched all the jobs in the Navy. I looked up, what do they do? What is the work-life balance? I looked up reviews on Google. Like, you have to do your research. That's the only advice I can give you all when it comes to picking a job for the Navy, for the military, for any branch. I know this video was kind of rushed and, you know, it's not professional like most of my videos, but it's okay. You know, sometimes it's what you got to do. But I got to go. I got things to do. I love you all. I want you all to continue to comment, continue to like, share. Make sure you subscribe. Turn on my post notifications, because as you can see, I'm getting these videos out. I will be constantly posting more and more and more videos. So if you want to see more videos from me, comment down below. Let me know what you want to see. Comment down below and let me know, and I promise I will get it to you, okay? Okay, but I gotta go. Y'all have a good day. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see y'all in my next video.